All right, guys, so today we're going to teach you very quickly how to build a web crawler and scraper using the water gem in Ruby. We're going to create an autofollow bot that logs into Instagram, navigates to the username and password, injects our information so that we can log in, clicks the login button, goes to a user's page, follows them, waits a few seconds, and unfollows them. So it's going to be very basic, but I'm going to try to get you up and running as quickly as possible. You want to install the water gem, which is right here. I'll link that below. But basically, it's a framework for Selenium, and it uses the Chrome driver. Everyone has a hard time downloading this. I'm not sure why it's always a pain, but it is always a pain. So I want you to download using Homebrew if you can. So it's going to be brew install Selenium. And then you're going to want to do gem install water, but it's water with an I. Let me type it in here. So that's the gem we're going to be using. There's going to be more advanced versions of this where I keep building off of it. I'm going to actually build a more advanced one of just this program that we build, a little bit more advanced using three other libraries and just making it a little bit cleaner and nicer looking. But for now, I'm going to keep it just as basic as possible. So this is the only gem we're going to be required to use today. Let me clear this. So the other thing I'm going to do is, because I have all my credentials in a local file, I'm going to require relative credentials. And I have them saved as global variables. So the variables we'll be using here is going to be, if I can type, which I can't because it's really hard to type and talk, actually. It's a lot harder than you'd think. Because normally, in a normal day when I'm working, I'm not talking and typing. Like, I might be on a meeting for a minute, but it's not like I'm trying to, like, rush through something. Anyways, so username is, for me, it's because it's a global variable in another file. It's $username, $password. For you, just put strings in there with your information. Like, if I was using my username, I could just do like that. So let's get rid of that. So we have our username, we have our password. Ooh. What else do we need? We want to pick the user that we're going to spam. And we'll go with Justin Bieber here for that. Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna wanna do is what? It's gonna be open the browser. If I can type, browser, navigate, login page. Yeah, let's just do that for now. So browser equals water. Browser dot new. And we're going to be using Chrome for this. In the next version, I'll show you how to use an incognito window as well. But for now, yeah, we're going to be using Chrome. So you will also need a Chrome driver, which I believe you get when you download Selenium. Otherwise, just you can Google search, or I'll link below, but it's pretty easy to download. And then we're going to want to now take the browser that we've just created and go to, let me just copy paste this, but it's instagram.com/accounts/login. And we don't even actually need all of this. We can just literally do that. And yeah, so we're good there. Now we want to navigate to the username and password. Okay, so yeah. Navigate to username and password fields. Inject our info. Inject info. Let's just say that. Puts logging in so we can see what's happening in the console easier. So how this is going to work. So when you're using water, it basically parses everything on the page, but you pull it individually. So like a text field, you actually pull by saying text underscore field. So it'd be browser dot text underscore field. Or if it was a button, we'd say dot button or dot label or whatever. And you'll see all that in the docs, but and we're gonna do it by name. So like if I come here to this username, I click inspect, you can see right here it says name equals username. So that's the attribute. You can basically go by any attribute that's there, but this is going to be the best one in this case because nothing else is going to be called username probably. So username all underscore, and we're going to say set to our username. And that should be it. Yep, that looks right. Okay, so actually we can just copy and paste this whole thing and just change the second one, the line 15, to password and password. Yep, so the next thing that we're gonna wanna do is click login button. So like I said, we can also use button as your field. Let's go with class for this one, because I've already looked this up and I know that it's the best way to do it. So if I inspect the login button, you can see down here it has these four different classes. Now I know, and you can do it, I can do it by text field or text input or whatever, or name. I forget what the exact field is, but where like I can literally search by the button's name, which is login. But we're not gonna do that. We're gonna use the classes here. So you can like search and try and figure out which exact class it is, but one, not only does it make the program less quick, but it makes it more vulnerable to bugs, because if something else happens to use that same class, in this case it's just a login page, so it probably won't, but it's best to just use all four classes, because it means that when it's parsing for everything, it's only gonna parse everything that has those four classes, which probably is gonna be just that item. It might be a couple more in other situations, but here's probably just that one item, and it's gonna be the fastest way to get this done. Now we're gonna say click, and that's it. So I'm gonna come down here a little bit, and I'm gonna sleep the program for 360 seconds. That gives us 5 minutes if we wanna take it. Once the program is going, I'm going to run the program now and see if I haven't made any mistakes while talking and typing. And it looks like it's working. So as you can see, it's navigating to Instagram. It entered my, and I did make a mistake. All right, so that's browser, not Bowser. Let's try that again. So it navigates to Instagram, it inputs my username into the username field, it inputs my password into the password field, and then it clicks login. And then we're logged in. All right, so we're good to go. I'm gonna go ahead, and to quit from the terminal, you can just hit Control C, or if you exit out of that browser, that works as well. The reason water is so good, and the reason why opening an actual browser is better in some cases than an HTTP client, is because there is firewalls to prevent HTTP clients from scraping the source of a page on websites, and opening in a browser surpasses that, because it can't tell that you're not an actual just browser being using their server. Okay, since we're going to be doing something else and it has to log into the page first, and that seemed to just take a second when we did that, I'm going to sleep for 2 seconds right here. And then next we're going to want to navigate to the actual user's page. So let's say navigate to user's page. And we're going to just do another go to. So browser dot, I can't type browser today. Dot go to. Let's see. No, it'll just be Instagram. Instagram.com/user. I have this page pulled up here. Yeah, Instagram.com/user, and then another forward slash. Cool. We're doing good. So right now that should take us to his page. Then, as you can see, there's a follow button on here. So if I click inspect there, you can pull the classes. I already have them pulled, just to make it easier. But it's these four right here. I'll copy and paste those. So now we're gonna wanna let's say as our note, if not following, because we're gonna get more into this in a minute. If not following, then follow. I have to create that capitalization there. I'm very anal about my comments. And we're just gonna say browser dot button. I'm gonna go by class. This is embarrassing. Nobody's gonna respect me after this video. All right. If I can finish typing, we'll get this program done in just a second. So we're gonna click. So it's gonna click follow. And just to get through this quicker, so I don't have to keep showing you each step. Like, I can assure you that that's what that's gonna do. I'll do more now and just debug it later. So if not following, then follow. Else. Oh, sorry, that's a comment. Else. Unfollow. So what we're gonna do here is basically do the same thing. It's a different set of classes. Oh. I'm gonna paste that in. And I'm going to pull those new classes from my notes that I have. And boom. So the only difference is actually the second class here, which is the actual identifier. But like I told you, using all four gets things done a little bit faster. So we're gonna say, here we're just gonna say puts following user. And we'll just copy and paste that down here, except we'll change it to unfollowing. This way we can keep track of it in the terminal. And we'll also add a sleep for 3 seconds so we can see what's going on. And then we want to add logic to make sure that in case, basically to make sure in case, like say we're already following Justin Bieber, which obviously I'm not, but if I was, I wouldn't want the program to time out because it can't find the follow button, this class right here, and have my program break. So we want to add a little logic here. Let's say if browser dot, oh, why can't I type browser today? Dot button. It's kind of funny, but this is when I'm tired, this is actually how I type. Like, this isn't just like it's not usually this bad because I'm talking, but it can be this way sometimes. So we're gonna actually use these same classes right here because we're checking to see if they exist. And we'll do exists, question mark. We'll indent these and we'll say N. All right, that looks good. I don't see anything wrong offhand. Let's copy and paste this down here under, let's do it under the sleep. Let's indent these. Let's pull these classes from down here for the unfollow button and place them up here. So we'll check if that exists. And we'll end, and then this should be the end of our program, so I'll bring the sleep up a little bit closer. I'll save it, let me clear my terminal. And yes, okay, so let me run this. If I haven't created any bugs, it should just log in, go to Justin Bieber's page, follow him, wait 3 seconds, and then unfollow him. All right, we went to his page. As you can see, I wasn't following him. It was blue a second ago. Now it's white. 3 seconds, unfollow. Everything shows up here in the terminal. Logging in, following Justin Bieber, unfollowing Justin Bieber. So that by itself is enough. I'm going to stop this program. That by itself is enough to show you how to crawl a page, how to click around, how to navigate through things, and just the basics of pulling information and injecting information. If you read the docs, this should give you a pretty clear understanding of how to make it more advanced and just playing with it. In the next few videos, I'll show you how to create an auto like button or auto like feature. And we'll make this one more advanced. We'll add also auto liking. And cool. All right, guys. Later.